Welcome to On Air with Kash. Our guest today has appeared in the hit series The Goldbergs, Family Guy, and Loving Lakin. I grew up watching her as Al every Friday night on Step by Step. Please welcome Christine Lakin.
Hi, Kash. Good to see you.
Christine, it is so great to have you on the show. I was at WME, voiceover department. You were one of many people who I grew up watching. I was like, oh my gosh, I get to work with these people every day. This is too cool. So I was a bit starstruck. I'm glad that we've kept in touch over the years. And you've just had such a phenomenal career. You made that transition from child star. You had so much success. And then you went to UCLA right after Step by Step. And you've had this great career, not only acting, but most of your credits too. They're directing credits. I mean, you do a lot of work behind the camera on some big shows.
Yeah, my career has been so interesting. I'm a proud Bruin, but I was a communications major because my parents were like, go do something useful with your degree, because what if you don't want to act anymore? And what if this business like is just, you want to just like chuck it out the window? But I have been very lucky because I've stayed in it for so long and I've done so many different things. I like to laugh that I'm a recovering actor, but of course I still love acting. I would still act any day, but I just felt at some point I was using my skills behind the scenes, working with young actors, you know, directing some of the episodics, from anything from that to like choreographing for so long. And you just keep reinventing yourself over and over and starting to do your own projects over and over. It's something that I guess just kind of came naturally. And so I'm just really thrilled that I continue to get doing what I love in all different capacities.
We actually have the same major. I was the same way where I wanted to study film, but then I think I had a similar conversation with my relatives as well. So I got a communications degree at CSUN.
Nice. That's a great school.
You also had mentioned a choreography because you are a nominated choreographer. And again, it's a lot of the shows that you've directed, specifically The Goldbergs. I know that you did some work on True Blood in the Westworld as well.
Yeah. You know, when I was young, even before I was on Step by Step, I was a dancer and for many years took dance classes and competed. And One step by step happened, it sort of took me out of that dance world for a while, but that was always something I just really enjoyed and loved. So in my 20s, I went back to my roots in theater and I met some of my best friends, and it was just really like a way for me to keep, you know, that passion alive, doing like different shows and performing in theater. And by happenstance, I was just the person who had a dance background. So I would end up choreographing a number here, assisting a choreographer there, being a dance captain. And it just was this career that kind of snowballed. And I fell into it, found myself working on a movie musical called Reefer Madness for Showtime. And I was assisting the choreographer, Marianne Kellogg. And then we worked together again on a movie called You Again. And then I started to kind of, my name started to get passed around to just do little episodics here and there and work with, you know, actors, because I understood actors, but I also understood dance and I also understood, you know, directing a little bit and like behind the scenes. I'd just been doing this again for so long. So when the Goldbergs came around 10 years ago, I started that very first year working with all of the young children at the time, who are now full-fledged, wonderful, beautiful adults. And we've, you know, people say, is there a lot of dancing on that show? Yes, there's a lot of dancing. There's a lot of flash dance. There's a lot of dirty dancing. Any 90s, 80s dancing that you can think of is on that show. So yeah, it's been really fun. So between that and then the spinoff Schooled with all the 90s stuff, it's kept me very busy over the last 10 years.
So what is it like being a 90s icon? And then you have these shows like The Goldbergs and School that are taking place like during an era that you were a part of.
It definitely feels very nostalgic, very full circle to many, to a degree. The thing that I always find is so funny is like when we'll be doing something and I'm explaining to the actors, for instance, like what the movie Swingers is about. And there's two young actors and they're like 14 years old. And I'm like, so you know that movie Swingers, right? And they're like looking at me like they have no idea what I'm talking about. And I find myself explaining to them as a director, like what the movie is so that they can then emulate it. And then I'm showing them, you know, YouTube videos of Vince Vaughn being like very inappropriate. And their parents are looking at me and I'm like, I'm sorry, this is the craft. Listen, this is the craft. They need to understand what this movie's about. We'll get past the language. We'll go to another scene. But yeah, it's, you know, it's just, it makes you feel like quite old in some ways, but then also I actually, you know, learned something growing up. I have some kind of knowledge to impart, I guess. So yeah.
Why is it always swingers? I know, like, for, you know, I guess we're the millennial generation, but for us, it's like, I remember watching that as a kid, and that was one of many movies when I was watching Step by Step, you know. So I'm like, you know, elementary school, if you're my age, then yes, that was your life Friday night. You know, you couldn't go out, you couldn't do anything. And those were the shows, you know. It was like, yeah, we say it for Family Matters, Boy Meets World, Step by Step, that order. Everyone in my class had a crush on your character, Al. And at the same time, we all wanted Al to be our friend. Like, Al was just so cool. You know, she was like the person we all wanted to hang out with as well. And growing up in issues that, you know, it was before I was really going through it, I felt like there were stuff that we can learn from that show. Or felt like Al went through some stuff we totally identified with, whatever. And Al never changed who she was. She was still like the cool person who was good at sports. She was popular and fun. So I really felt like you set a good example for a lot of us, and a lot of things that your character went through and you demonstrated on the show helped, you know, my generation and people growing up watching.
Oh, yeah. Thank you very much. You know, I think you did a really good job back in. I feel like we don't really have that kind of television anymore, that co-viewership, where I felt the same way. I mean, I was 12 when I started on Step by Step, and TGIF was my life. Yeah, I had been watching Friday night television. I'm such a fan. The fact that I was going to be on a show that then was going to be on Friday night. I mean, are you kidding me? It was like, it was incredible. It just was like everything to me. But the thing that I love, and like, I've recently been rewatching it. Stacey Keenan and I are working on a podcast in which we rewatch the episodes. And it's interesting because she's never seen them. She's never watched them ever.
Stacey Keenan, who played Dana, she's never seen an episode of Step by Step.
She's never seen an episode. So she's now seen 18 episodes. We're on, I think that's where we are in season one. So it's pretty fun to watch them and then chat about it with her. Just like chat about the things that we remember from behind the scenes, what our lives were like then, how they're, you know, what it was like growing up on television. Those producers and those writers did particularly well was create sort of this appointment television for families in which there were kids going through all kinds of stuff. Step by Step was clearly a show where not all the kids got along. We were not picture perfect. We all had, you know, some kind of issue. And it, yes, there would be resolution, but I do feel, and a lot of people have said that, you know, it really gave them a lot of support. They felt like there was someone to relate to in that crazy family. And especially for kids of divorce, because nobody had really talked about that or brought that into the mainstream. So yeah, it was a wonderful, wonderful experience and a really, truly great memory for me. So I feel very lucky.
Ah, well, that just makes me feel great because again, I just have fond memories of my friends and going through stuff. And then, you know, then we fast forward. It's like, I just really admired your journey too. I mean, even, you know, I know we got to work a bit together at WME when I was just, you know, graduated college and starting out. But then, you know, really when I looked into your career and I was, you know, you think that they're just acting credits, but you were like, no, she's also a choreographer. She was, you know, Christine's a director as well too. And, you know, even I'm aware of that podcast, but I've seen you on other talk shows too. Over the years, you know, you're adamant about where you are in your career. And just like what you were saying with the pulling up those clips, because I mean, I feel like, you know, we were probably watching the same stuff around the same time. And in the 90s, I mean, that's when like Tarantino, Paul Thomas Anderson, and Swingers was just such a huge, it was really like even the next decade when I started like pursuing acting more actively, it was like there was always a scene from Swingers or it was really LA at that time. I mean, there's just those moments when they're like, whose part is this? I don't know. Or there's all those. We all knew characters like that. And it's funny because I'll talk to someone younger too and be like, you got to watch, like, because they all know Vince Vaughn from, I think, you know, Wedding Crashers and everything on, where I'm like, no, you got to like watch like 90s Vince Vaughn.
Yeah, totally. Like I said, I feel like so lucky that I continue to get to do what I love to do. And if that's creating behind the scenes, if that's, you know, creating with actors, that's in front of the camera, if that's a voiceover, if I'm choreographing something, if I'm directing something, producing it, like, I've had my hand in so many different pots in this business, and I feel like part of that has been just because I can't not continue to just reinvent myself and find a way into this business. But also it has been, for me anyway, I was given this advice that you're only as good as the last thing you did. And that can be a bit of a detriment too. But as we all know, like, this business moves very fast. And I guess I always wanted to create more avenues so that I could keep doing what I love. And it's been a real journey. I mean, I definitely feel like I've been a little bit of a jack of all trades, but I've loved them all. And I think they've all been informed what I do now. I had no idea that that's what I was doing. I had no idea that I was, accruing all these job titles so that I would understand, at some point how to direct a television show, but that's sort of the way it worked.
I think you're living in the moment. I feel like you, by talking, you just embrace what's around you. I feel like we're a lot alike in that respect, where the agency thing, the producing, and I was like, for me, like in my 20s, I was like, I want to get back into acting and producing. And you can't fight what's in you. I mean, I grew up in the industry too. My dad was a music executive. My mom had worked for Johnny Carson, the Beach Boys. And I think later on, dad grew up with the creator of Full House. So there was always times I was around that crowd as well, with Jodie and Candace, I'd run into them at parties. So some new, people that I know from Disney from, the 2000s, and they're all directors now too. They were all child stars, and it's that thing, they all want to be directors. And so it's interesting to see how the generations have kind of carried this tradition of spawning new filmmakers. And speaking of, because you recently directed an episode of High School Musical, the musical, the series, and you also just directed A Life by Ella.
Yeah, High School Musical. I had an episode in season 3, and it came out a couple weeks ago. My episode is 6. It's Color War. So much fun. I mean, just an incredible experience. The best crew, the best producers, the most talented cast. I can't say enough about them. It was truly just a wonderful experience. It was very, very gratifying and very challenging. We were shooting mostly outside. This whole season takes place mostly at a summer camp. So we were outside for a lot of it, and there were, always a huge production number, if not one, two. There were some stunts in this one. So I had my work cut out for me, for sure. I was really happy with the way it turned out. And I can't say enough about that whole cast. And then, Life by Ella, we actually shot late last year, but it's just now all coming out. All the episodes have dropped on Apple Plus, and it's all available now, season 1. And again, just really wonderful, beautiful actors. It's essentially about a young girl who has gone through cancer, and she's recovered, and she's trying to figure out how to live her life again and live her life without fear. So it's a poignant show. There's a lot of really heavy acting moments just done so beautifully, but it's also funny. It's also like real life, So the ups and the downs of this family as they navigate this one girl's journey. And Lily Brooks O'Brien, who plays the title role of Ella, is just an incredible young actress. And in many ways reminded me of myself when I was that age. This was her first starring role and in a TV series. She's done lots of Broadway and lots of, side parts and supporting roles. But it was really incredible to watch her work. And she has a very deep well of emotion that she can just very quickly tap into. Her process was incredible. So I hope that I was, and I think that I was quite supportive of that. And we had a lot of good chats, off camera, just talking about what it means to be an actor and how you have to protect your gift and protect your art and, the longevity of not burning out in those types of environments, because it is very demanding, that kind of job, and to enjoy every moment of it. I'm very proud of both of those.
It's very inspiring to see where your career has gone and the passion that you have for your work and your crew. It really shows in the work as well. And I understand our paths are going to cross yet again, because the Burbank International Film Festival is starting this week. It's running September 8th through the 11th. I'm going to be there opening night, hosting the Q&A for the premiere of The Way Out, starring Mike Manning, Ashley Murray, and Sherry Shepherd. And I know that you are hosting the gala for closing night.
I am, and I'm very excited about it. Seeing young filmmakers and new filmmakers, indie filmmakers, put their work out there, it's really exciting to me. People and their craft. I mean, it's the reason we're all in this. And I don't think anyone ever stops learning. I don't think anyone ever stops being inspired. Even when you think you've had your last good idea, there will always be something else. And so for me, I'm thrilled to be there. I'm thrilled to present some awards, and it's really wonderful to come together as a community and support art.
I'm honored to be mentioned in the same festival this year. Everyone, please give it up for Christine Lakin. If you're my age, you know you grew up watching her, and you got to get on Amazon and get your kids into step-by-step reruns, educate them about classic family television. She's had a fascinating career as a filmmaker, The Goldbergs, The High School Musical, The Series, and catch her new show, Life by Ella, on Apple Plus. Christine, you've really been someone who I looked up to, and it's an honor talking to you. I'm proud of you and your work. You managed to do it all. You've had this successful career as an actress, a filmmaker, dedicated wife and mother. Keep inspiring, and you keep creating great work. And we will see you at the Burbank International Film Festival. Catch me opening night, September 8th. Get your tickets, The Way Out. And you also got to get your tickets for the closing night gala featuring the host right here, Christine Lakin. Thank you so much. And you just keep rocking.
Thanks, Kash. You too. I look forward to seeing you there.
Yeah. Thank you so much for rocking out with me and Christine Lakin today. You are on air with Kash.